Okay, here we are in After Effects, and there's nothing artsy going on here. This is just if you're trying to draw attention to a certain piece of text without using highlights and other things like that. So I've got this text right here, and it's a PDF. I'm going to drag and drop that into a new document. And to show very quickly where I got this, I went to filorama.io, and I clicked on Star Wars, and I just got all this. I just selected it all and threw it in a PDF. And I ended up with a whole bunch of text that just kind of references the whole Star Wars New Hope. And when you're dealing with text in a PDF, it's going to be a vector object. So sometimes it's best just to hit this collapse transformations. And you can scale it up as high as you want, and it will never rasterize or get pixelated on you and all that. That's just a little tip. There are many different ways you can do to draw attention to text, but the way we're going to do it today is go to layer, new adjustment layer. Nothing happens because until you put something on this invisible adjustment layer, nothing's going to happen. So we're going to go over here to effect, color correction, and I'm going to hit HSL. That's hue, saturation, and lightness. And we're gonna just draw that back a little bit and make it a little bit darker for us. And you do that kind of just do whatever you please. And next we're gonna hit the letter Q and make sure that we have the rectangular shape chosen. And with our adjustment layer selected, we're going to just kind of draw a big long rectangle right there over that text. And as you look at this, you go, okay, that's not what I want. I need to highlight that. So you can hit the invert, but I'm just going to go ahead and on this drop down here, you're going to subtract. That's going to give us sort of what we want. And then if you hit the letter F, that's going to bring up the feather for this mask property. And we want to feather that just a little bit. And then you go, okay, what if I want to animate that on? Well, you can do that too. You can go out here about a second or so. We're already here, so we might as well start at the end. And we hit a keyframe, go back to our beginning, and hit the letter V, and with the mask path selected, all of your points are going to be selected as well. So let me control Z to that. You're gonna have to hit on something like maybe the mask feather here, and that way everything goes hollow here, and you just pick the points that you want to animate. You hit the shift maybe if you have to, and you go back, and then you hit mask path again, click that, and you hit function F9 if you want to. You animate any way you want to. I'm kind of an easy ease person, and there you go, it kind of animates that on for you. So that's one way to do that. And what if I wanted to do something where all this text here was bright white, and then it just gradually darkened, and except for the text that we wanted to highlight. Let me go ahead and turn off the stopwatch for this, and that way it kills all the animation because we don't want that right now. You go up here to the rectangle tool. You don't select it, you just double click it. Okay, notice when I double click it, the whole darn thing just went dark on us. That's what we want. And whenever you create a mask and then you create another larger mask inside of that, they interact with each other. Okay, so right now it's in add mode. If you take it down to subtract, now everything is bright white. And you go down here to this mask opacity, and let's say we keyframe it here at 100%, go out about a second, and we just take that mask opacity back down for that much larger mask that we have here. And that's how you get everything to be bright highlighted and then make everything around it go dark. Or conversely, you can go back up here and go to add mode again, and that way the entire document itself will be dark, and now you're only affecting what's inside this top mask up here. That's how the interaction of these mask layers works. So this is just simple document animation type stuff. If you're trying to highlight a tweet or a post or something like that, and you just want to do something, you see this a lot in very informative documentaries, things like that. Anyway, there you have it.